Love it or loathe it, you can't say it's not artistic, can you?
No. And a very different man now, lying in 14th place. And he is tremendous technically. How good will he be tonight in the free? Lying in 14th place, he was 19th last year in Lausanne. Guo Zhengjin from Harbin in China. Start triple axel, triple toe loop. Now he can do a quad toe, and this might well be where it is right here.
Fantastic quad toe, triple toe combination.
In the program, there's another quad toe scheduled. That was the triple Lutz, and he's looking very good. Just 19 years old, an amazing prospect.
This, you may well be asking yourself, how come he's down in 14th place? It was from a mistake on the double axel, would you believe? And here's the triple loop.
Out of nowhere. He's reeling him off, and next, if he's gonna have the stamina and the guts to do it, should be a quad toe after this little bit of artistry. Not able to hold on to that. But very nearly. just 19 years old, and as far as the jumps go, a supreme technician. Have to say, Chris, though, it was a routine that, for all its brilliance in the jumping department, left me a little cold. He's got to work hard. He's only 19, of course. With maturity will come that extra artistry, but he's got to work hard on it, because for a while there, he seemed to be just going through the motions. Jump, then going through the motions, another jump. Jumps were very impressive, but there's got to be more than that.
Yeah, the jumps were very, very impressive indeed. A fantastic technique. We'll look again at the combination right at the beginning. Quadruple toe, four turns in the air, takes off really early after that drop three. A good landing, a little bit over the toe, but still able to get triple toe on the end.
And he did four so comfortably, you have a feeling he could even do five.
Yeah, maybe. Certainly looking at the triple salco, you'd think he could quad the sal as well.
Because he kind of over-rotated here.
Yeah, a little bit too much. Well, maybe he can, but maybe, you know, where's it all going to end, I ask myself. But you're dead right. The technical side was brilliant, but the artistic impression mark is really going to suffer. Not only was there very little presentation, but the spins in the program weren't good either. So that's another reason why he finds himself so low down. Of course, in the short program, there's three jumps, three spins, two step sequences.
Normally with figure skating, you have two distinct marks, and something goes wrong technically and the second mark is a lot higher. Here, you'd expect the first mark to be a lot higher.
Well, of course, the technical mark does reflect the difficulty of the spins as well.
Yeah,
so
true.
There's an opportunity for the judges not to go overboard with the first mark, although the quality of the jumps was excellent.
But the judges have gone with him as far as the technical mark's concerned. 5-4 up to 5-6. Of course, the Chinese don't have a member of that panel, but no need for the influence. But yes, the second mark way down, 4-6 to 5-0. But he's left his impression as Guo Xinjin, and in the lead at the moment.